يا خاور لم دق الخسر بثلايا
شو لان زكيان انا سومن
وداليتنا ولا مز العالم
شمن من يقدش شو بقي الأشنين
شمن خزان زيش أبو سلوات ربو
شمن قد قرنا شو قيثار وخنار
شمن قبلتي وروعي شبخو مين خلياثا
شبخو سسلا شو شو قالا وقعتا
ومن نشمع شبخ مريا
شبخ
مريا كل خنامي شبخ كل نماثا وطوضا اشنا اغلام طيب وزاق شاري رايت مريا والعالم دخل خوشيا ومارا قيمين ذم مدقا
شبخنا على روخ القدشة من عالم وضم العالم من غامين دخل خوشيا ومارا قيمين ذم مدقا
صلي اشنا معنا
قابل كل عيان ياخو طيب وضعك السلاحة الأفرايا بتموضى قدير وشفوضى الأجداد وقعتم كل تمريتين كل أضراني كل طوعات النار وبريان كل باب أبرونا وفرا قدش
العالمين آمين
شفاستيدا عن شفاتيدا يمت شفاختا بيشن بوخان باسمه متوى قيب وارخا بقف الخان بريان دفاه وسيمه وذر ومعني مالكم باب أبرونا وفرا قدش العالمين بسم الله خان جمع الكوث قابل ندش مشتوخن طيب ودخنا نعمين
آمين
لا خمار كل مردين لا عيشان شيخم شقنين لا تم نخمان الباري وتبار هو بدن شرنا
شيخ الجفعي تيجي وركيخ المطلب مريم
made known to me by revelation. as I have written briefly earlier. When you read this, you can understand my insight into the mystery of Christ, which was not made known to a human being in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles are coerced members of the same body and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. Of this I became a minister by the gift of God, grace that was granted me in accord with the exercise of his power. To me, the very last and least of all the holy ones, this grace was given to preach to Gentiles the incurable riches of Christ and to bring to light for all what is the plan of mysteries hidden from ages past in God who created all things, so that manifold wisdom of God might now be made known through the church to the principality and authorities in the heavens. This was according to the eternal purpose that he accomplished in Christ Jesus our Lord, in whom we have boldness of speech and confidence of access through faith in him. So I ask you not to lose the heart over my affliction for you. This is your glory.
I'm glad. نور باطور خلص اللون ما مريتا
داخل المغرب نور يمشي خيا من العولة أنجا والياوتا وقلب المريا عمره ما جا
of St. Luke. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greeting you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at this word and wondered what kind of greeting this may be. But the angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I'm a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who was said to be unable to conceive is in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail. I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled."
Allah'ın peri
قلتك ادخل لي الله بعين منا
اراني صراخ القائل Oh,
طيب ودور رقم العالمين امين
اطلب السماء
مقراط اليوم قم مقراط النشاء قائد لقراءة خدوتا شمقراط النشاء وطفقا رقواتك واضمريتو بابا برونا ورب الشرفي أضيت رزا يبدا إيموثا
شيخا زيكا موسى من جوثا دشميا
طيبوث المراني شمشيخا قبلنا ورشوتا موثا طلوخا قدشتا عم كلنا هرشا وخطبا والعالم أهمي
and
خير غني شمخيان أغايك الذا أخشي خان
بشار
وَأَنْتَ الْقَائِلُ تَنَاوَتَ Actually service as a deacon, our beloved Shamash Raul David, after his surgery. May God bless you, Shamash, always. and guide you in your life, give you always healthy life with you and your family always.
Amen.
And this period of time, actually, as a church, which is the period of Annunciation, and by the way, the church calendar actually starts the first Sunday of Annunciation. The last Sunday was the beginning of the church calendar. That's why the church put this calendar actually for the people of God, like us, to see the providence, the divine providence in our life, and to live our life according to His providence. And that the old way the church actually started the calendar with the four weeks, which is symbols of cross, and end with the 4 weeks symbol of cross. That means we start our calendar with the cross and end it with the cross. Why we call it Annunciation, the period of Annunciation? We call it in Surah Sobah, which is mean Shirda. Always the Annunciation, it's as a word of Sobara, we use it for the good news. We cannot actually use Sobara with the bad news. That's right. What is the good news here? The good news here is that God actually looked to our nature, to our humanity, and He came down and incarnated. That is the good news, which is the Word became a flesh and dwelt among us and became part of our life, and which is, we call it today, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the Word of God. That is the great news, and the good news, we call it Annunciation, which is so far. Today, and the Gospel was from Luke chapter 1, verse 26 until 38. We saw how the angel actually came to Virgin Mary and announced her that she gonna actually start this salvation, or let's say it this way, the great salvation that humanity will receive through our Lord Jesus Christ. Although that, like the rest of Israel, Mary waited for God's visitation to His people, she didn't expect that she would receive this privilege from God through the angel's visit to her to preach that God, the Trinity, had a plan for her life and an invitation to her. Her dialogue with the angel showed that she didn't give herself a privileged position. So she was frightened. The Word of God came to give her peace. "Don't be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God." She believed that God was determined to fulfill His promise to Abraham and to his descendants, and would continue to do so through it. She continued to live a life of faith in Him as one God. "I am the Lord's servant," in the end, Virgin Mary said. She gave Him all her life, knowing all the difficulties that this call requires, especially that she will walk this way alone. But she believed, she had a trust that God will never leave her. The angel actually left her and let her face the challenges of this invitation on her own, a task that requires her to be listening and praying. Therefore, the evangelist Luke presents her as an example for the believer, for the church that bears God's word of salvation in the world and for the world. The Annunciation of the angel to Mary also revealed to us that word of eternity, as we prayed in our liturgy, the great secret that was hidden of centuries and generations manifests to us at the end of time, which is that the only one in His Father's Lamb came and took the servant's body with His grace to told us and reveal to us the complete faith in the Trinity. that we can see it in the second Sunday in the hymn of Dwasalibe we call it. Incarnation has always been a divine providence. We ask, what is the reason for divine incarnation? Why Jesus actually came down and incarnated? Is our sin the cause of God's present and incarnate him as a human being? The church's answer to this question is the love of God that has driven him to be with us, not our sins. And his love will transit our sins and invite us to repent to him and return to his father, to our fatherly home. Love makes him man, with man incarnated Emmanuel. His incarnation gives salvation to mankind, redemption to our life. The Annunciation to Mary reveals to us also the love of God that has made him close to man who doesn't know how to get close to him. Even if he tried, he mistakes and goes repeatedly. Therefore, it's necessary for God to come down and correct what man has corrupted and reconcile him to his heart. Our Christianity promises us God's promise for man. See how great a love the Father has given us that would be called children of God. And in fact, we are children of God. The first letter of John, chapter 3, verse 1. Who will accept this love and believe in it will be saved and will be children of God. Our God and our King, because he is love, he always wanted to be with man. But it was man who chose disobedience a lot of time in his life. That's why today, as we listen to the word of God that has preached Mary, it is telling us that he is present in her and with her. And she accepts him as a God in her life to serve him with complete obedience and generous love. She invites us to learn to stand in his presence and be ready for everything he is asking for of us, even if it seems unreasonable sometimes to us. Let us learn from Mary how to transfer our self asking, how can I be faithful in my faith, as Virgin Mary did in her life. With her obedience, actually, God's providence starts with our humanity. That's why our salvation is achieved when we accept his will in our lives with free and modest obedience, without ever thinking that we are distinct from others. That's how our faith is in our life, to listen to the word of God as Virgin Mary actually did, and we receive salvation. That's how plan of God starts with us by that listen. May the Lord bless you all and guide you in your life, and wish you all a healthy life and prosperity always. Within this Holy Qurban, we mention the name Esther Shimon because of her memory of the 40th day. She departed this life. May our Lord account her with a multitude in his kingdom. Amen. And also we mention name of the late Marian David, which is today for her 1 year of her memory. Marian David is wife of John David. May God rest her soul with a righteous woman in his kingdom. Amen. I would love to announce you again also. The next time we're going to come here will be in December 24th. December 24th is actually the Christmas, which is the Saturday, the Christmas Eve. December 24th, 2022, we're going to be the next time here within this parish to celebrate the Christmas feast, feast within you and celebrate it together with me. And also I would love to ask everybody to keep Samira Salem in your prayer. She needs our prayer actually, and for the speed recovery, amen. There is all need done, and ask the Lord to forgive our trespasses and our sin, and make us both to receive his body and blood for this occasion, amen. بارك ما عبدنا
فيه.
يا الله طاوى مليلة رحمة our good and merciful God whose grace and compassion are poured out upon all. Pour out my Lord your compassion and kindness upon these your servants. Change them through the hope of renewal again to a changed life. Renew within them your Holy Spirit with which they were sealed into the day of salvation. Purify them in your compassion from all defilement of flesh and spirit. Strengthen the hope of their faith through the assistance of your grace. Guide the steps of their ways and the pathway of righteousness and grant them the light with the sense in your kingdom through the truth of the hope of their faith and the adoption of sons. And gladness and the observant mysteries strengthen them through the assistance of your mercies that they may keep your commands and fulfill your will and confess worship and praise your holy name, O Lord of all. Father and Son and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you.
For the gift of the holy mysteries which you have given us and your compassion for the pardon of our debts. O Lord of all, Father and Son and Holy Spirit, forever. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed is your worshipful honor from your exalted place, O Christ. You have forgiven our debts and sins and make our offices to pass away through your glorious, holy, life-giving and divine mysteries. O Christ, the hope of our nature, always and forever. Amen.
Amen.
May our Lord Jesus Christ, whom we have celebrated and honored his glorious, holy life given and divine mysteries, the most worthy of the seemly glory of his kingdom of delight with his holy angels of confidence before him and of standing at his right hand in the Jerusalem above through his grace and mercies, to whom be glory and upon us and all creation. May the right hand of his glory goodness rest now, always and forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
May the Holy Qurbana be blessed for you all and God your new life go with peace. Allah barakakum, 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 Allah barakakum,